Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be just kind of a heart-to-heart, a life update, a casual chat because I haven't filmed in a very long time. I did start vlogging this morning, but I wanted to sit down and film this video because honestly, I have been thinking about what I'm gonna say in this video for probably 3 months and have just kept putting it off and things kept changing and I just hadn't blocked out the time to do it, and that's what I've been struggling with a lot. And I'm gonna talk about my burnout and just like all the things that I have been kind of not keeping from you guys but also not letting you in on, and I feel like I'm finally ready to like talk about things and where I'm at, if that makes sense. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video to some extent, and I definitely recommend getting a drink or a snack or something because I don't know how long this video is going to be. And of course, in true me fashion, I have a very long list on my phone of notes. So hopefully I can express to you what I want to say in this video. This is also a little bit of a trigger warning. I am going to be talking about depression and anxiety, and if you're not available to hear those topics at the moment, that's totally cool. I'll see you guys in my next video, but just kind of a heads up. So I wanted to start off, I'm gonna be reading off my notes, but I'm gonna be starting off talking about my burnout. And if you saw my Instagram post, I think it was like last week or something, if not, I will have it linked down below. There's only so much you can say in an Instagram caption, and what I originally wrote was actually a lot longer than that, but I basically just said how the past few months I've been feeling super tired and run down and burnt out, and I recently passed my 10 years on YouTube, which is a long friggin' time to be sharing your life and posting consistently and just talking about honestly really random mundane things that don't really matter in the grand scheme of life when it comes to like hair products and makeup and all the fluffy stuff that obviously I love and I enjoy, but at some point I'm like, what is this even for? What am I even doing here? And I just feel like I got to that point, and I feel like that's pretty natural when you've been doing something for 10 years and you haven't taken a break and you haven't had any just like downtime from it. Because the thing with social media as your job, which I mentioned also in that post, is that you are never not thinking about growing your business. And I feel like I have been in the mindset, and selfishly in the mindset, excuse me, for 10 years on how do I do better? How do I make more money? How do I succeed? How do I grow my numbers? How do I get more views? How do I this? How do I that? And I'm just like so mentally drained from this toxic cycle of what I'm going through. And I feel like social media is obviously so lovely and I'm so lucky to have the job I do, but oh my god, I'm tired because it's just exhausting when you feel like you're not doing enough constantly. Like you feel like you're never good enough because there's always going to be someone doing better, always going to be someone posting more, and it's just this constant battle with yourself of like, no, it's okay, I am doing everything I need to do, I'm doing the best to my ability. But then there's also the other side of like, I'm never doing enough because there's always someone else doing more, and that's like so toxic, as you guys can probably see. And it's just gotten to a point where I'm like, I don't really care anymore. I don't care, and I don't know what I don't care about, and that is why I'm going to therapy. So I have known that I needed to go see a therapist for quite a while now, and probably like the past year I've been like, I should do that, and it got to a point where I'm like, no, I should actually go do that. So I had a bunch of different calls last week with different people that I had been recommended, and then I've chosen one. I haven't actually gone to an actual session, but I have one booked for next Monday, so I'm really excited about that. And I just feel like that's something I really needed to do for myself and honestly should have done a long time ago. So that's in motion and I'm really happy about that, and I'm excited to kind of talk to her about my burnout and things like that, because like I said, I have been burnt out before. I've been burnt out many times. I used to get burnt out in high school after like dance shows and stuff and like too much stimulation with like all the things that people in high school deal with, and I was able to take a mental day and I was able to just sit at home and relax and stuff, and I feel like then I was recovered. But now I just feel like I have burnt out so hard that I need like a longer time to recover, or I'm having a lot harder of a time recovering, if that makes any sense. I just feel like I've never been burnt out this long, and so I'm like, I should probably go get help. Along with my burnout, I have been reading. I'm a really slow reader, FYI, and I've shared this on my Instagram, but I was recommended this book at teacher training for dance, which I will get into, that's part of the life update thing. But my dance instructor, dance mentor, Vanessa, she mentioned this book, and she did a kind of workshop on a lot of the practices in here, and during that workshop I cried because I related to so much of what she said and what was in this book, so I knew I had to read it. I'm just over halfway, so I'm not finished, but I've really been enjoying it. It's called High Performance Habits, and you can also get it as a free audiobook on Spotify, I believe. I will have this link down below along with the audiobook, so if you're in kind of a similar state of mind as I am, unfortunately, I definitely recommend this. I feel like it's really helped me kind of reevaluate what I want to move forward doing. Also in the book, he talks about different ways that high performers live their lives, and if you kind of don't utilize these tools and these certain things, you are gonna burn out, and I feel like that's where the relatability comes in. And also just being a high performer, because I am my own boss, I am the person creating my career and doing all the work, I don't have a team or anything, I feel like it's super super relevant to my life. So anyway, highly recommend that if you guys are interested. So aside from my burnout, a thing that I'm doing to counteract that is to prioritize things that make me happy. So I've been socializing and hanging out with my friends a lot more and just doing activities that I know will make me feel good and fill my cup up in different ways. And it's been a really interesting realization, because I feel like so much of my job and my career is so selfish, and I've always kind of considered myself a very selfish person. Also being an only child, I feel like that's kind of natural, and obviously that's not a really great trait to have, but it's true, because so much of my life depends on my success, if that makes sense. Obviously that's kind of true for everyone, but in this career more so, like what you put into it is what you're gonna get out of it. And I just realized that so much of my process and thought was always going into me, 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 and never like, what can I do for other people? And I feel like that's just such an interesting thing to take a step back and look about, or look on, look at, whatever. And so the past couple months, I've been prioritizing things that make me happy, and that involves my friends and hanging out with them and doing fun things and prioritizing community and dance. You guys already know dance is a huge part of my life and has been for a really long time, but as an adult, I've been dancing with this company or these people for about, I think it's been 7 years, but in what's called company for 4 years. This is my fourth year. And I've also joined the HQ team. So I'm now running the social media accounts. So that's their TikTok and their Instagram. And I have not worked for someone else or been a part of a team in any capacity for so many years, like since I worked at like Cineplex and Boston Pizza, honestly. It's been so nice and refreshing having this little side gig, and honestly something else to focus my energy and my creative juices on, and something that doesn't involve me on camera, which is so great because I get to flex all of my creativity when it comes to content creation, but I don't need to be the center of it, and I can enlist other people to be a part of it and collaborate and have ideas and just communicate back and forth. And it has been so amazing, and I feel like it's so natural to want to do something that brings you so much joy and just like go balls to the wall for it. And so that's basically what I did. I've been dancing so much more. I think I'm dancing like 4 or 5 times a week now, which is amazing. My body's never felt better. I'll get to that in a physical dance way. Anyway, I've truly, like, my mental capacity when it comes to dance has been really really great, and I've really been enjoying that job. So that's another reason why I haven't really been posting as much, because I've been focusing a lot of energy, although it's a very much part-time gig, and like social media managing is kind of just a side thing. It's been fun, and so I've been taking a lot of time to do that and work on that. And like any social media, it's very different hours, it's not a set schedule whatsoever, but I've been focusing a lot of time and energy into my dance, and it's been really really fun, and I'm just really happy to be a part of that team in a bigger capacity now, and I've really been enjoying it. And like I said, it's just been so nice to flex my creative muscles in a very very different way, but also be appreciated and be a part of a really awesome team. So that is that. Like I said, I'm gonna be all over the place. I wanted to talk about my burnout and my anxiety, PMDD. So a couple months ago, I had noticed right before my periods, I actually watched Christy's video recently, Raw Beauty Christy. She did like a life update chat video recently, her first time posting in a while too. I feel like we're going through similar things, although I'm not a mom. And she actually talked about PMDD, and it's just like severe PMS symptoms. And I did not know what was going on, but every time just before my period the past couple months, because of my burnout, and that obviously leads to other things and other stressors, I had all of these like mental breakdowns, like the days leading up to my period. I was so anxious, I was so sad, I was just, everything was so extreme and it felt like nothing was ever gonna get better. And then I wouldn't say it like magically disappeared every time my period started, but it like eased up a little bit. And I saw this pattern starting to happen. I was like, okay, I need to go do something about this because this anxiety is so not normal for me. I was having what was similar to like panic attacks, and I was showing up in spaces with people in a way I didn't really want to be showing up, and that wasn't feeling like myself. And so I did end up going to the doctor. I'm not gonna talk too much because it is kind of personal, but I am on medication now, which I didn't really think would be something my doctor would prescribe right away, but I'm also not opposed to it because at that point I was like, you know what, anything to help. And I'm on such a low dose that it's hopefully helping. I've only been on it for about a month, but I have noticed a improvement, not a major improvement because it's not some magic pill. But this time before my period, I had a lot less symptoms and I was in a lot better headspace, and so that's how I knew I improved. And yeah, I'm just kind of trying things out and seeing how it goes. So essentially I've been taking medication, I'm going to be going to therapy, I'm doing what I think for me personally are the right steps in order to feeling better and to getting back to feeling like myself. I've just kind of explained it to people that I haven't been motivated to take care of myself in that way. I'm really good at like the bath and the self-care and that kind of stuff, but when it comes to like the actual healing and the self-care for the long term, that's what I struggle with. I'm very much a person that just wants to put a band-aid on it and keep going, but that is exactly what led me to burnout. So that's what I'm trying to fix. And then when it comes to like my eating habits and things like that, I have not been feeling motivated in the slightest to cook, to feed myself anything nutritious, or be gluten-free, because I'm supposed to be gluten-free and dairy-free. I have not been giving a shit about any of that because I don't have the capacity. We've been ordering food takeout. Cody's working weird hours and it's just been really awful to find any sort of motivation when it comes to eating healthy, especially this time of year when it gets dark at like 4 p.m., which is another whole thing that I don't want to talk about because I hate it so much. But yeah, it's just been struggling over here, and I'm sure that's super relatable. I feel like a lot of people this time of year get really uninspired when it comes to these kind of things, and I just want you to know that like that's super normal, and I feel like I go through this every year, but this year it just feels a lot heavier. And so I've been trying to make myself feel better by like making juices and stuff. I got a juicer from my parents for my birthday that I've been loving, and that's like at least something nutritious I can easily make and have in the morning. But when it comes to meals, I just have been not caring and not motivated. So if you have any good inspiration or recipes or easy meal ideas for gluten-free, dairy-free, or like any tips, please share those in the comments because I need some inspiration for that for sure. Kind of along with that and not feeling motivated to do literally anything, I feel like I've worn less makeup in the past 5 months than I have my entire adult life. I just simply don't care about getting ready. I find it so difficult, and I feel like by the time I do get ready, it's dark outside again and I just feel like I've wasted my time. Or if I have something to do that day, I focus around that and I feel like I can't do anything else. I've been really bad at time managing, which is something I'm normally pretty good at, and I'm good at prioritizing things that like absolutely need to get done, but if there's like, if it only 75% needs to get done, it's not getting done, and I've been really bad about that. So I'm trying to be a little bit better with my time management and time blocking, but adjusting to a new schedule of dancing pretty much every single night along with having to do other social media work, and then my social media work and creative and filming and editing, all of the other stuff that I do for my own content has just kind of been pushed to the wayside a little bit because I've been prioritizing other things, but it's just been kind of hard figuring out a schedule, and I feel like I'm not ever gonna have a schedule because it's really difficult to have a schedule with this kind of work. But I'm trying my best, and Google Calendar has been my best friend. Also too, I have completely gotten rid of any planner notebook things. I have notebooks that I write things in, but like as for a planner, I'm not using it. I'm just using Google Calendar, and everything I have to do, like my to-do list and everything for daily stuff, is just in my notes app on my phone. It keeps it really simple, really straightforward, and really easy. And I just feel like I was overcomplicating my life by having so many planners and like having to write things down and put it in the Google Calendar. I've just gotten rid of all of that and simplified my life, and it's made a big difference when it comes to prioritizing and organizing what I absolutely have to do. So that is everything that I have written down in my notes to share with you in this video. I know this video was all over the place because that is just what my brain is right now and my mind. And I'm not sitting here being like I'm magically cured of my burnout. I definitely am not. I'm still very much in it, but I'm, as you guys heard, I'm doing actionable steps to hopefully feel better in the coming months, coming weeks. All we can do is hope. And I'm definitely in better spirits, and I feel like that's a huge, huge win when it comes to now moving forward and dealing with it. And I do also want to say, because I mentioned this in my Instagram post too, is that like obviously in a dream world I'd love to take like 6 months off. I'd love that. I realize that like although yes I probably could do that, I don't really want to. One, because I do love what I do, don't get me wrong, I do love this job. It's been a lot lately, and I feel like taking time off for a long period of time wouldn't benefit me anyway, because I'd be so scared that I would lose everything I've worked for. And maybe that's not true, maybe it is. Social media is so weird and unpredictable, and I've never done that to know. I feel like I don't have that big of a following to be able to do that, if that makes sense. Also, another major factor is the fact that when it comes to this kind of work, you have to do it consistently in order to get paid. So I have to be posting YouTube videos, I have to be doing brand deals and sponsorships, and truthfully, this is the busiest time of the year and usually the highest paying, to be completely honest, when it comes to brands and budgets and everything for working with companies. So that's another reason that I don't really want to take a ton of time off. I by no means am doing Vlogmas or forcing myself to film anything. I don't want to, because that doesn't benefit any of us. But I am like making a promise to myself on the days that I'm feeling good, like today, I'm going to film and try my best and, you know, create content for you guys. And that's the other thing too, is that I just feel so bad for being so sad on the internet all the time. You guys have enough shit in your own lives. Why do you even care about mine? Like, why should you? I just never really understood that. And I feel like I've just been so sad and like depressed and like things like that on the internet the past year or so. And I feel like there comes a point where I'm like, I don't want to bring you guys down with me, but I also don't want to lose that honesty with you guys. I don't want to come on here by any means and fake it, because that does not benefit either of us. But just know that like when I'm filming, it's because I choose to, and that because I want to. And so I'm, like I said, only doing it when I feel up to it, and that comes with like Instagram and everything else too. So just wanted to make that note. I still very much love what I'm doing. It's just been a little bit difficult lately, and so I wanted to let you guys know how I've been feeling. And thank you so much for those of you that have stuck around to watch the rest of this video, but also have just been supporting me on Instagram and all the lovely comments you left on that post. I didn't get back to literally any of you, but I appreciate you all so much. And it's honestly because of you guys that I want to continue this. I could so easily, well, I'm gonna get choked up. Let's see if I can get through this without crying. I do know that if I wanted to quit YouTube and quit social media, I could go do another job, maybe in the same field, maybe not. I know that there's other opportunities, and of course the camera turns off right when I'm filming this, but obviously I do have other career options and opportunities I could go after, but I choose not to because I love the creative freedom that this job brings me, and I love talking to you guys and being a part of a community that I get to share things with you. And like, I can't thank you enough for letting me be a part of your day, whether that has been for the past 10 years or the past year, and whether that's like you watching my Instagram stories at night or watching YouTube videos ever so often. Like, all of it means so much to me, and I'm just so lucky to be in this space with you guys, and I do not take it for granted. And that is why I feel so much guilt when it comes to not being my best or feeling my best or creating my best for you guys. And I know that I have so much more I can offer you guys and talk about and share with you, but I haven't figured out the best way to do it yet, if that makes sense. I don't know. I'm still obviously working through a lot of things, but hopefully you guys don't mind also being on that journey with me and not having me just disappear for a couple months and come back. Who knows? But I just wanted to let you guys know where I'm at. I think I've rambled on enough. Noodle's trying to get in, and I'm probably going to continue crying for the next hour, but I'm going to leave you with, I love you. Thank you so much if you've made it to the end of the video. I appreciate you more than you will ever know, and I hope to see you guys very soon.